Hello and welcome to my channel Local Guy. My home have two floors. On ground floor I get Wi-Fi signal, but on first floor I get weak signal or no signal. I want to extend my Wi-Fi range to first floor, so I will put another router on first floor and will connect it to ground floor router. In this video I am going to show you how to connect two TP-Link routers using WDS, Wireless Distribution System Bridge. Before starting the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe first and watch the video till the end. Here is my main root router or primary router, which is TP-Link TDW8970, which is connected to internet. My root router SSID name is Falcon 1 and IP address is 192.168.1.1. If you want to find your router IP address, then on computer open command prompt and type ipconfig, where default gateway is your router's IP address. Open browser and type the IP address to access the root router web page. Login with credentials. Here my username is admin, password is also admin. The DHCP settings of the main root router is from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.199. So any device trying to connect to this router will get IP address from this range only. Under wireless settings, you can see that my SSID is Falcon 1 and password is time 0000. Now I want to extend my Wi-Fi network range. For that I have another router, which is TP-Link TLWR841N, which I will use as an extender router on first floor. At the backside of this router, all the information regarding login and SSID is given. So let's turn on the extender router, connect to Wi-Fi network. SSID name is TP-Link E0FA and password pin is 7669379 as printed on this sticker. Now, to access the extended router, open web browser and type http://tplinkwifi.net. Login with username admin and password admin as given. Now go to network and under LAN, change the IP address of extended router to the same subnet as main root router. Our root router IP address is 192.168.1.1. and DHCP range is 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.199. So we have to choose IP address from this subnet only. So let's assign 192.168.1.110 to extender router and save it, then reboot. As we have changed the extender router's IP address, so now on browser type the new IP address to access the extender router, which is 192.168.1.110, and login. Now go to DHCP and under DHCP settings, disable the DHCP server. Now any device trying to connect with extender router will get the IP address from our root router. Root router will act as a DHCP server. So device will get IP address from the range 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.199 only. Now comes the main part, WDS bridge settings. For that, go to wireless and under wireless settings, you can change the SSID as you want. We will change it after WDS settings. Now enable WDS bridging, new settings will show up. To enter SSID and BSSID, click on survey. Here you can see the list of available Wi-Fi network SSID name to connect. Falcon 1 is root router SSID. Click on connect. Then provide the Wi-Fi password of the root router, which is time 0000. On status, you can see that WDS is running. Now reboot the router and that's it. Now extender router is connected with root router using WDS bridge. Now let's connect to extended router and check the internet working or not. You can see that internet is working. You can see that root router DHCP has provided the same subnet IP address 192.168.1.127, which is from the range 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.199. Now you can change the SSID name of the network and password as you want. First change SSID, then change password after that. Let's connect to new network SSID and check the internet connection once again. You can see that it's working. So this is how to connect two router wirelessly using WDS bridge to increase or extend Wi-Fi network range. Thanks for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel Local Guy.